Welcome back to another episode of Kylie Bites the Dust. We're trying to defeat Sir Artorias, although, to be honest, I'm not really sure why I'm trying. Oh, the fire is nice and bright and tall. Sir Artorias seems to be optional at this point, and just really strong. Okay, so this is how I'll be going into battle. Like a kid who's putting a costume together based on whatever they can find in the reject pile. But blocking should be a bit better in terms of dealing with Sir Artorias. Okay. Got back my 29,000, which is neat. To do that. Health is a risky business. I really want to get some health back. Oh boy. Oh, that was risky. Got it. One more hit should do it. Yes. Soul of Artorias, and the shield seems to have made all the difference. Thank you, shield. Oh, wow. Wow, sir. From Sir Artorias, we have two doorways, and I can't for the life of me tell them apart. Right, so this is where I came from. Which means I'm going to go a long way around just to see if there's any treasure or hidden doors. So, Sir Artorias was swallowed by the abyss. He could not handle it. And now he's in the land of Ulisile. Now I'm in a place where there's far too many directions to choose from. Surely these stairs just go up to the higher level and that's it? Victim of the abyss. So the soul of Lord Gwyn's knight Artorias, who was consumed by the abyss. The legend that Artorias repelled the abyss only told half the story. It seems that he was defeated, and his honour preserved, by some unsung hero who is the true victor over the abyss. Unsung hero who is the true victor. Would that be me? And again, we have two ways to choose from. Guess I'll go forward. What? There's more. Well, I guess I'll go this way. Up, there's a locked door. Could I jump over this? Okay, so I think Ben nearly laughed at me, so maybe I'll take that as a sign not to. But seriously, if I fell, I wouldn't die. I'd just fall down there. What about the other side? But I guess also I have 79,000 souls now, so I should probably do something about that. Like level up, perhaps? Come on, surely this is jumpable. Surely this is. Like, why would they put two equal-sized holes here and not want me to go over there? It's destiny. I am destined to jump over there, where there is probably nothing. I don't know. Okay, let's see if I can jump. I can test this. Can I jump over this hole? A testable thing. I'd say they're about the same size. Okay. All right. So maybe you have a point. Maybe these holes are a bit too big. I cannot jump far enough. But it looks so. Nah. All right. Fine. 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 Fine, fine, fine. I can't get out onto that ledge. Nope. Okay. Now what? There's straight ahead. There's a bonfire, so I guess I should probably use that. Stamina. So does this continue? Yes, it does. Okay, well, let's check out the other side first. Let's see what lies over here. Lots of different markings. Whoa. What? Battle of Stoicism Gazebo? Looking duel. This is a Ben writes PvP. Ah, only available online. Okay. Right, so this is an online facility. Okay, so I guess this doesn't work. If I were to click something to. Oh, I don't want deathmatch. Team Ruins. Deathmatch, nope. Team. So these would be single players, duel. So let's say if I were to pick one. How is this working? I thought it was only online. Am I online? Well, I'm here now, so. So, duel. Wait for competitors on trapdoor. Shut off your rings. Okay, so this would only work. Yep, okay. Okay, so I can come to the area, but I won't be able to fight anyone because no one will appear, I suppose. Neat. What's this? Alright. Retire to gazebo. Bye bye. So I have come back to the Battle of Stoicism gazebo as king. I'm sure Ben will show it all in the cutscene, so you won't be able to see it in person, but I killed everyone I came up against and I returned the victor. There was a glorious crown on my head and I've put it away. I would show you the crown, but like I said, Ben cut it all out, so sorry, I'll have to show you. So, now that I have schooled so many people in my wonderful fighting ways, I continue in my solo journey into the Ulisile Township with this fellow, who is very friendly, and is now dead. He was the fellow that got stabbed by Sir Artorias. Got wiped around. Sir Artorias literally wiped the floor with him. And I don't think that did much. That roof looks walkable. Yum yum. Can I jump onto that roof? No. And I've got company. But I am quicker. So, no problem. Around the perimeter. Tra la 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 la. There's a lift. Is that all there is, or is there something more behind the lift? There's more behind the lift. Wow, they remind me of my sisters. I suppose since I'm here, let's change this to getting some HP back. And, yes. Hidden chambery bit. Oh shit. I've been poisoned. So poison looks like it's going to be a thing. Oh. Okay, let's deal with him first. Wasn't sure if he was going to attack me, so I wasn't going to attack him. But he was mean, so. Nice. Purple coward's crystal. Victory in this battle once led to ancient Anor Londo, but even in the absence of its overseer, capitulation is a disgrace. In the name of a warrior's honour, do not quickly resort to use this crystal. Very nice. So we're going to cure poison, and then we're going to Homeward Bone. Going further than I intended. Yep. Okay, backtrack a bit and let's go the other way. Sure. Come along. A very good carving. Oh boy, my favorite. I don't know what that is. I don't even know where it would be. Aha. Very good carving. Arch tree carving says very good. Okay, so this is a head carved of arch trees by Gough in his imprisonment. Gough imparts an emotion to each and every completed carving, which helps him achieve personal enlightenment. When a head is disturbed, it speaks, reflecting the emotion conferred to it. This head says very good. Have another look. Does it not appear quite jovial? How do I...
Very good!
I really hope I didn't need that for later. Oh, I still have it. Fantastic. Very good. From here, this goes further and further. Conceivably jump down there, I suppose. But I'm not going to. Ow! Ow, my jaw! Ow! 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 Oh, shit again. Alright, let's deal with you quickly, I guess. Run! Oh! Ow, my jaw! Ow! click. Might need to see a dentist about that. Ah! I think I popped my jaw out. Okay, so. Sorcerer thing is down, but not without significant damage, not just to my character, but to me! Blah. You look redder than usual. What's around the corner? See a treasure, but that's a trap. Why do they have glowing red eyes? They didn't all have that, did they? What's different here? And this clearly goes on for a long time. So I kind of feel like backtracking and going that other way again. Rubbish! Yay, I have my rubbish back. Oh shit, hello, hello. Hi, where'd you come from? What? Where? Up there, maybe. Is there a way up there? Oh, down to 3 Estus flasks as well. That is not good. Oh, they're dancing synchronized. Very good. Okay, I can see a problem. The problem is that there's a lot of them. I don't want to deal with lots of them. Alright, these notice me. Whoa, what's that? What's that about? Is that an area of effect? Oh crap, 2 of them. Alright, let's deal with them quickly. Oh shit. This is where I die, huh? Yep, this is where I die. And now we're back to where my souls were. Where are they? They are there. Can I jump down on top of these people? Oh. Would be glad to target you. Large Titanite shard for the trouble and my souls. Perfect. Know what that's there for. Game designers, what goes through your mind when you make little archways that don't actually go anywhere? Little sewery bits. What about synchronized dancing? Although I hear footsteps, which means someone is active. Is active. I hear footsteps. There is another sorcery person too. Oh, yep, found it. Okay. What are they doing up there? And why is their magic not coming down past their level? And where are the footsteps coming from? That's unfortunate. He looks angry. Yeah, he wants me. So now, oh boy, let's back up a bit. Oof. Okay, so we have a sorcerer who has come down now. Persons first, cure the poison. This is no laughing matter. So again, we have a door. It doesn't seem to do much. We have a treasure. We have, oh, dark fog. Now this is where the map starts to get confusing again. Because you have all these different options of places to go. Dark fog seems like a spell, so... Dark fog. Abyss sorcery, discovered by an Ulasile sorcerer on the brink of madness. Create a cloud of dark fog. This is what I saw the sorcerer using, I guess. Although dark fog is, in theory, relatively close to humanity, it also happens to be a terrible poison for humans. Perhaps it reflects man's cruelty against his own. Gotcha. I'm getting poisoned a lot because I guess my resistances are not as big as they need to be. A fireplace. Not a hidden secret fireplace like it was last time. So in terms of options, we've got one door, two, anything this way, fake door, three. This doesn't seem to actually go anywhere except for the treasure. Is this safe to get to? Ben is sneezing. See, he's real. I'm not just making him up. Could you imagine me playing this for the whole time and you're just a fictional character? That would make me so... strange. So it looks like we have two main doors. The one that goes upstairs and the one that goes across into that main arena. I have two humanity as well, which is neat. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go up first. I think that will be the smaller route. And there'll be some monsters up here to fight, I suppose. And I'm not sure what else to expect up here. Ah, well. Ah, I suppose this goes quite a distance as well. Oh, shoot. See, there is a treasure chest. How do I get to it when I can't jump that far? Whoa, what's that? Let's have a closer look. There's a chest. Is there a door? really tell. I'm guessing no. Which means it should be jumpable. But to where? To there? Can't jump that far. To there, maybe? I'll just end up down there, so it's not like this is a huge risk, but... How do I get to you? Is that... Oh, it's hard to tell. I don't think that's a door. It just looks like a couple of stones that are stuck out, but there's one bit at the very bottom with a bit of a dark bit that I can't... No, that's... surely it's not a door. Surely I have to be able to jump across somehow. I guess I'll try and jump to there. But... nope. I can't climb up there. How... Maybe that bit of wood. Also, how do I get over there? Ah! Where'd you come from? Oh my gosh. I've gotta stop doing that. There's another chest in there. Try and run into there, I suppose. Oh, they're really good at scaring me. Crest key. Oh my god. Bent crest key. The grooves of the crest are enchanted, the door sealed with a powerful spell. That's probably the door I saw before that was locked. So that will be something to explore. This fire is lit. They know how to put fires on. Okay, now there are way too many options. There's a roof I can walk on that goes who knows where, and then there's a... oh god. Alright, I've got to map this. If I go on the roof, I probably drop down further. So let's go on the ladder, I guess. What's here? Don't know. Seemingly nothing. Where does it drop down to? The floor. Now I guess we can try going onto the roof, but just in case this kills me, I'm going to change my equipment to... the Ring of Sacrifice. So far, so good. And I could jump down further, or I can go around. Twin. in humanities. Now, if I jump down further, I eventually end up on this balcony thing. Yep, sure. Why not? What's this place? Ah, this is the outside bit. Ah, I getcha. Excellent. Well, I will come out here later. Let's keep... Ooh. There's a treasure. No, I got that already. Ah, well, let's keep exploring upstairs. Ah. I seem to have been here already. Uh-huh. Well, problem solved. Now I'm going to try and jump onto that piece of wood. See if that will actually hold me. Oh boy, I'm hearing that banging again. Ah, yes! Yes, yes, yes! Okay, so I'm going to walk across this one. Walk across this one. Aha! Chest! Real chest! Red titanite chunk. Woohoo! What's in here? This is a door. Oh. Where does it go? The planks are falling out beneath my feet, are they? Am I imagining that? This appears to be a blank room. I don't know why. I'm in a blank room. I don't know why this room is here. Game developers, help me out. Why did you put this room here? So here we are. Now, I thought I saw some really high steps, so I hope that this way eventually leads that way. Because I thought going up before would take me there, but it seems like it doesn't. Some windows on this side. A door with a lift. Ah, yes, I definitely want to. Yes. Good, this should take me back upstairs, I think. And activate that shortcut. Beautiful. You know what this means? It means I can explore that other path now. Which was this way. Yes. Get to you. Hmm. brave warrior. Thank you very much. And then I guess I do that again and jump down here. Let there be light. Uh-oh. What's that noise? What's that noise? What's that noise? What's it after? Something's going on. Here there is two pathways. Oh, I am so lost. Somehow come full circle. Ah, gotcha. So when I go back in that room again, now weird things started happening when I came over here. Let there be light, and then booming noises and giggling. Because I have to stand on the message. Coming from there. Okay, so nothing's happening. Well, I guess I'll keep exploring. And I'll go downstairs this time. Wasn't ready for you. What? Two of the chests have already been opened. What the? Who? Who takes my treasure? What have they left for me? Dark Orb. That would be another spell. Dark Orb. Abyss sorcery discovered by an Ulysseal sorcerer on the brink of madness. Fire giant dark orb. In contrast to standard soul sorceries, abyss sorceries are weighty and inflict physical damage. Perhaps human souls, because of their humanity, produce sorceries with more tangible presence. I am too dumb to use this. But thank you anyway. There is no way I'm going to make that. It makes it look like I should try, but I'm not going to. So, see ya, but I might try from further up. Was up here, I think. Yes, because I came down from. Came down from here. That's right, came down from here. And then there was this option which had nothing in it, as far as I could tell, except for the option to jump down there, which, no. Oh, hello. I'm sorry, carving. Nice. This head says, "I'm sorry," an expression of atonement. Okay, let's try that again. Apparently, it wasn't sorry.
I'm sorry.
Now, there's no way I'm going to be able to jump to that. That's a roof job, I think. Get onto that roof, get onto that roof, get down there. Can't jump there from up here. This is not the way to go, and jumping from down there is also not going to work. How do I use arrows? Ah, it's a fake door. That settles that. I don't know how to get out of this. Whew, okay. So, fake door is a fake door. I have explored all the treasure chests. The only option is back up. What's this about? Says, let there be light. I don't know what kind of light you need. I mean, I'm meant to provide some light. Only light I have is a lantern and a headpiece thingy, but I don't think that's what you mean. If we were to change this to the maggot. Fine then. That was embarrassing. Yep, that was embarrassing. So, turns out all it needed was some light. Ah. And I got a silver pendant. Silver pendant deflects dark. Silver pendant engraved with the crest of Artorias, one of the ancient treasures of Enelondo, presented to Artorias for facing the abyss, effectively deflects the dark of the abyss, especially in its magic forms. I don't know when to use it. I'm actually scared to use it. I would like more strength, I think. Although dexterity helps just as much. Nope, strength it is. Strength it is, 29,000 souls, and it is also two humanity as well. Which I guess I could use to kindle the fire, But that's a decision for when I come back. So, thank you very much for watching. This is Kylie playing the Dark Souls Blind Run, and I'll see you again very soon. Bye for now.